R&I, and they're interviewing people on the island, locals and visitors, and just about their experiences over the years and how the island's changed.
Hi everybody, we're today going for a wild camp on top of a mountain summit, and where we go exactly, Robert will tell you.
Well, today we're going to go up to Castilla Bill for up there for a wild camp. First of all, we're going to go through the forest, then we'll go up over the ridge you can see there with the light brown up there and follow that ridge, and that ridge takes us right up to the Castilla Bill, which we will be pitching the tents.
And as you have seen, probably we got a lift from Ellie up to the North Sanox car park where we started our trip today. And he is active in the mountain rescue team here on the Isle of Arran. And when you want to support the mountain rescue, I will put you the link in the description and up in the video. And you can also buy just some merch or something, for example a buff, which is really handy for cold temperatures. You can use it as a hat or a scarf, and you also support the mountain rescues. Just such a difference to do things like this with a big rucksack. Need to be super careful, but we did it. Dry feet?
Dry feet.
Excellent, we both have dry feet. And we are now just heading straight up here to the ridgeline and then up here. Kind of boggy in places here. That's good. We are now up the first bump, which was basically from the river to here, like 180 altitude meters. And from now on, it should be more plain sailing, just along the ridge. Unfortunately, it's in the clouds, but hey, maybe it will clear up. So we both just decided to put rain jackets on and cover the rucksacks, because it's kind of drippy when you walk through the cloud and there's not really any need to get the stuff wet. And when we have anyway the rain stuff with us, it would be kind of stupid not to use it. And the castle, I just call it castle, where we go up the mountain for our wild camp, is like 791 altitude meters high, and right now we are at nearly 500, so it's really just a short hike to get up, but the view should be really good later on. And according to the forecast, in the next hour it should clear up, and yeah, hopefully the forecast is right. So beautiful. It's literally for the last half an hour we have like the fog bow, which changes to a broken spectra every so often. Stunning, absolutely stunning. Absolutely awesome. It's incredible. And the tent which I'm using today is a Scarp One from Tarp Tent. Maybe a lot of you people know this one already. And yeah, should be a little bit windy tonight, according to the forecast, 30 to 40 kilometers per hour. And I use first the ground sheet from the Lanchon underneath. I don't think that we would need it on the ground, but better to protect it. I mean, there's probably no need for it, but I carried them up, the cross poles, and I definitely want to try them. And I'm not sure if the forecast is right or not. And even then, I think they're oversized, but hey, probably understand me when you get stuff that you just want to try it all out. And this is the first time for me that I tried the scarp, so I just put them in. And the cross poles, you just click in, and that's it, and then you can tighten them later. But I first want to click them all in. And you can order it seam sealed, or that you do it by yourself. And I ordered it that I do it by myself. Or I did it already, the seam sealing, which is a pretty straightforward process. Easy to do, takes not too long, so. Oh, that's basically it. I could also put here some guy lines out, but I don't even bother about it, I'm honest. This is, it shouldn't get this windy at all. Yep. So this is how it stands. And from inside, I have like my Samrus Neo X Lite, then the Yeti 400 again. I have a sick down jacket for tonight, and I have also my gear inside, my rucksack. And here I have something to eat, photography stuff, batteries, a drone, and for later on cooking. But I put all the stuff usually in the tent. I don't like it in the vestibule, even when it would be big enough and I can adjust it with this tent, but it's like, I don't know, I just like it. All inside, nothing gets in bed, and I have it all sorted when I need it. It's easy accessible, don't need to open any door. So, and Robert uses today the Mirage again, which is a stunning little tent. It's amazing, but for a beautiful scenery we have here. Oh, you have here, I see, you put yourself a thing down.
Yeah, I've just made a wee thing there, just to put the stuff on, just to make sure it's okay. Nice and comfy in here. Got my thermal rest, put that down as well, just a wee bit extra. And I brought my winter sleeping bag. Keep it cozy.
Excellent. I think we will enjoy a bit more of the stunning views here with Ciervoor. How do you pronounce it?
Ciervoor.
Oh, Ciervoor.
Ciervoor.
Ciervoor. Absolutely outstanding. So this is probably where we go tomorrow, but we just checked the forecast and apparently it should rain from 8 o'clock on. We will see. I would like to get the sunrise from here for photography, for some pictures, but we will see. Yeah, and that's us. Just beautiful. I mean, a video can't give it back really how nice it is here when you're above the clouds. We walked through the clouds with the fog. It was wet. It was so worth the effort. It's so nice when the forecast is right and plans work out. Just love it. Yeah, it's immediately really fresh when we're out of the sun or in the cloud now again. It's like unbelievable how fresh it is. I'm now in the tent. Yeah, so outside is really foggy and wet and everything, so there's no need to be outside. It's like now 6 o'clock. I know it's a really early night, but I wanted to show you how it looks inside. As I mentioned, I'm 1.87 meters, and here at the rear, I almost touch the end, and when I lay down on the top, I have like here. Yeah, I would say like 20 centimeters. When I sit straight, tight. Yeah, not much space, but yeah, usually I'm laying in the tent. Quite like it. It's a nice tent. You have plenty of space. I have here all my camera stuff in this corner. I have here my rucksack and my down jacket. The down jacket is wet from the fog. But I took it in the tent. I know it's not the smartest thing to do, but I don't want to put it into the vestibule because maybe I need it tomorrow, maybe not. So we will get a lot of condensation inside. Wonder how the Scarpan will perform, and hey, see you tomorrow morning and good night.
Good morning, folks. It was a really long night, kind of windy and rain in between and everything. I will pack now the stuff slowly together, get sorted. Sunrise is in roughly 40 minutes. And then it's the last end. I will put in the rain the tent away. I just attach it outside to the rucksack, and then we are going down direction Glen Rosa. Yeah, rather kind of windy. And no motivation. That's not helping. The weather forecast is not promising. It shouldn't get much better. Actually, it should get only worse. More windy and a bit more rain. So let us get started. So folks, we are now all packed up, ready to go down. I think I will finish here the video. There's not really anything to see. It's just a strong wind and fog. And hey, I hope you enjoyed our wild camp up the castle of Isle of Arran, and hey, see you next time. Bye!